see on my right and to your left on the stage, a Southern fancy dancer from the Cheyenne and the Kiowa tribe, Mr. Bruce Nicconi. Next to him, we have a young man by the name of Jay Yule in the feather dancing outfit. He's also from Marshall Williamson from the Sac and Fox tribe, a grass dancer. Next to him, a prairie chicken dancer from the Kiowa tribe, David Coleman. Next to him, a young lady with a northern shawl dress. And she's from the Sac and Fox tribe, Taylor Stanley. Next to her, her grandmother. Her name is Pawnee Duncan from the Pawnee Sac and Fox tribe. Next to her, Laura Bushyhead from the Creek Cheyenne tribe. Thank you. The Plains Indian Dancers, let's give them a big round of applause. If you're out there within the sound of my voice and would like to see these performances, come on in. You still got plenty of time. You know, there was a time many years ago when the various tribes would gather together. Sometimes they would stay together 2-3 weeks at a time. While they were together, they would not only break bread with one another, but they would also exchange cultural ideas, songs, and dances. And in the cool of the evening, no matter what tribe they were from, each one would don the outfits of their own tribe, dancing in their own tribal style, sometimes in the colors of their clan. No matter where that song was from, no matter what tribe it was from, they all danced to the same song. And in today's powwow world, we call this the intertribal. Turn the clock back to a long time ago when the ladies were not allowed to dance in the arena with the men. What they would do, they would bring a blanket out, spread it on the ground outside the dance arena, and they would stand on that blanket and dance. But in today's society, the ladies dance right alongside the men, much added attraction to the powwow scene. And you know, there was a time when the government was fearful of the uprisings, so what they would do, they made the military take the clothing from the people, the buckskin, the beadwork, and the featherwork, and they put it in great, huge piles and set it on fire. To replace their clothing, they gave them what was known at that time period as trade cloth, in hopes that the ladies would take this material and make outfits similar to what the non-Indian community was wearing. But being very innovative, the ladies took this material and they gave it, they made out of this material traditional clothing out of it. Thus they have to keep alive the tradition and the culture of the people. So in today's powwow world, we have not only the buckskin dresses that are worn, But we also have the cloth dresses that are worn. So we're going to show you this style from the Northern and the Southern ladies. The original ladies dance, very slow and very graceful style of dance called the ladies traditional dance. Ladies, thank you, singers. You know, some of the original warriors of the Northern Plains people, we're going to show you that style now. They come from up in the northern parts of the Plains area, on up into the regions of Canada. You know, the grass at one time would grow as tall as a man. So in order to have the dances, they had to figure out a way that they could knock down this grass so they could dance. So this very special warrior society was given them the responsibility to knock down this grass. So they asked them to devise a way that they could not only move their arms around, but their legs as well, to knock down the grass in preparation for the dance. And while they were dancing, they would also pray for this ground to be danced upon, asking God to bless it. At this time, we want to show you this style of dance called the Northern Excuse me, folks. I'm 82 years old. Sometimes my mind isn't with me. Sometimes I forget what I'm going to say. Okay, let's get a chance to dance. Thank you, the grass dance. This next dance is a story dance. It tells of two warriors out on the hunt, looking for the grain to take home to their family. They happen to be from different tribes.
I don't think they have Apache this year.
So when they met one another out on the hunt, they began to challenge each other. Challenging them, they ended up in a fight. We call this the Spear and Shield Dance. Let's give a big round of applause. Once again, we're going to look to the north to our brothers up in the northern parts of the United States, on up into the region of Canada. And this was called a prairie chicken dance, was what they decided to do. These warriors were very, very much alive as far as being able to kill others. They knew how the wars went, and they knew how to kill. They learned this style from the prairie chicken, because the prairie chicken was very famous for being unafraid of any animals on the prairie. They would sometimes even back down the badgers that came to them. So at this time, we're going to show you this style of dancing that was brought about by going out on the prairies early in the morning while the dew was still settling on the ground. They watched these prairie chickens, the male species of the species, and they would watch them strutting around trying to draw the attention of the females of this species. So they got this style from them. So at this time we want to show you this very special style of dance called the prairie chicken dance. And watch, if you will, see if you can see the movements of the prairie chicken from years ago. Chicken dance. You know, there was a time when the young ladies grew tired of dancing like the original ladies. They wanted to dance fancy like the men, so what they decided to do, they took the feathers from the gentlemen, from the men, they put them on their own back, and they started dancing with the men. Many times they danced in contest with the men. I know this because my sister-in-law, Shayla Roland, was the very first lady to ever beat the men in contest in a place called Anadarko, Oklahoma, many years ago. The men grew tired of the ladies beating them. So what they determined, it's okay to dance fancy, but you need to do it in a more ladylike fashion. Thus the ladies from the north developed these fancy shawls, many, many colors on them in many cases. They decided that they were going to go out into the prairies and watch the butterflies as they went from flower to flower, and they took some of their style by watching them. And in today's powwow world, when these young ladies dance in contest, there may be 20 or 30 of them out in the dance arena at the same time. Every color imaginable out there in the arena. Very special style of dancing that's very popular throughout the United States today. So everywhere you go to see a powwow, you'll see a fancy shawl dancer. So at this time, we want to show you this style, fancy shawl. You know, years ago, around the turn of the century, the feather bustles at that time, well, there was only one that these gentlemen would wear on their back. But there was one evening at a place called White Eagle near Ponca City, Oklahoma, that a young man by the name of Gus McDonald, of the Ponca tribe, he stepped into the arena one Saturday evening with two feather bustles on his back. Since that time, that feather dancers have evolved to what you're going to see next. We sometimes refer to these gentlemen as the quarter horses of the powwow scene. They're so fast and so colorful in their style of dancing. When their contests are announced today, what they do, the people come running from all over the powwow grounds to watch them. But we're going to show you this style of dance, very popular throughout the United States, the Southern Fancy Dance. When you see something you like, let them hear it. The more you cheer and holler for them, the faster they're going to dance. Folks out there that wants to go on a diet, forget it. Just learn how to do that dance and you'll be okay. We told you early on we like to do not only an entertaining style of show, years ago.
I got an up front seat, wouldn't you say?
Here's a big round of applause. You know, we told you early on we like to do not only an entertaining style of show, but one that's educational as well. But we're going to test your memories as we bring all of our dancers out one more time, see if you can remember what we told you about their style of dance, and perhaps where they're from within the plains areas of these United States. At this time, the entire group.